Because he was small, Stetson had been left behind for a much larger hunting dog. Now he hunted for food and shelter in the busy ski town of Park City.
Hi, my name is Stetson. I am a 2-year-old terrier. I live in Park City, Utah. This is my story. I need to find a home soon. It's getting cold out here, and I'm hungry. Oh, oops. Anything to eat? Should I go up the street or down?
Because he was small, Stetson, the tan and brown terrier, could easily hide under the stairs of Alex's bistro. Each evening, he looked out between the steps to watch the sun drop behind the Wasatch Mountains. Tonight, the bitter cold rushed in with a roar. He crouched deeper into his small space and tucked his black button nose under his front paws. As dry powder blanketed the small opening under the stairs, the sounds of the town were calming, slowing, muffled by new snow. Stetson's heart ached as he watched the dinner crowd scurry home to their warm fires. He wondered why his soul felt so hollow.
He awoke to the clatter of skis, the chatter of voices, and the smell of bacon.
Ooh, something smells good.
Because he was small, he had to sidestep the clumpity clump of ski boots tramping up the hill. He made his way to the Morning Ray Cafe, and with a nobody ever feeds me face, he whined hungrily as the crowds brushed past him.
If I give them the look, I hope, I really hope, somebody will share their breakfast with me.
Again and again, the door opened and closed with a whoosh, each time blowing snow into his nose. The small terrier sadly lowered his head. Soon, a pair of fire-red ski boots stopped in front of him. Stetson looked up to a warm croissant. A hand reached down to brush the snow from his curly wet back. Stetson responded with a full-body smile. The croissant was his, but the fire-red ski boots became lost in the crowd.
something smells good.
That afternoon, clouds covered the sun and the sky darkened. Biting cold seeped into his small bones. Just down Main Street, light from a low window cast a golden glow onto the ice-trunked sidewalk. The book-filled windows of Dolly's bookstore looked warm and inviting inside. When the door opened, Stetson made a run for it. No one noticed him as he ran to the back of the store. Near the children's section, he found an old cowboy hat, worn and velvety. Because he was small, he could fit right into the silk-lined crown of the hat, hidden from view. There, amidst the bustle of the store, his anxious heartbeat slowed, and his little feet warmed. Never had he felt so comfortable, and the little tan and brown terrier fell asleep.
When the door opened, Stetson made a run for it. No one noticed him as he ran to the back of the store. Near the children's section, he found an old...
A moment later, Stetson was jerked awake by the skippity-hop of children's feet shuffling in for story time. He bolted out the back door.